I moved to Puerto Rico alone in October of 2020, 7 months after the pandemic had started. So when I got here, I had to quarantine for 2 weeks, which actually worked out pretty well because that was about the time it took for my car to be shipped from the United States to San Juan. So after my 2 weeks of quarantine, I had my car and I was finally able to get out and about a little bit more in Ponce. In those few weeks between when my car got here and before I started working in the yoga studio, I used to go shopping at a grocery store or pharmacy or at Walmart almost every day. Partly because, yes, I needed things for my apartment, but also because truly I wasn't getting that much in-person human interaction at that point. That sounds so pathetic, but it's true. I was teaching, I had my online students, I worked from home. I wasn't yet really established in the community. The only people I knew were Kelly and her family. So those little trips to the grocery store, the pharmacy, el colmado, the cash and carry, Walmart, and the small talk I would make with my cashier as I was checking out was a great way for me to practice a little bit of Spanish and also get some much needed human connection. So for that reason, this episode on shopping a lo Boricua is close to my heart. Before I had friends, I had cashiers. Hello and welcome to Learn Spanish a lo Boricua podcast. Today, we're going over everything we talked about in the episode before, episode 44, on shopping a lo Boricua. We're going to cover all of the vocab and the phrases you need in a grocery store and a pharmacy, el colmado, which is like the local corner store, your neighborhood store, and at the mall. I highly recommend you view today's episode on YouTube. You need the visual piece in order for these phrases, this vocab to stick. The link to view the episode on YouTube is right there in the podcast description. Just as we did in the episode, we're going to start with the grocery store, okay? El supermercado. And our first steps are preparándote para hacer compras, okay? Preparándote para hacer compras means preparing yourself to go grocery shopping, which yes, the phrase hacer compras in Puerto Rico is how you express to go grocery shopping or to do grocery shopping. A few other words that can help you prepare to hacer compras. La lista de compras. La lista de compras would be your grocery list. Las bolsas reusables. Let's save the planet, por favor. Las bolsas reusables y más, because as we talked about in the episode and what we'll get into in just a minute here, you have to pay for plastic bags in Puerto Rico. Okay, so bring your bolsa reusables, your reusable bags. Once you get to the grocery store, you may choose to grab a carrito. El carrito is cart. El carrito. Or una canasta. Canasta is going to be your basket. La canasta. The video that we recorded in the supermarket is a great resource for my visual learners. It's going to be popping up in some corner right now, your YouTube video, if you'd like to go check that out. It's a short video. Literally, it's a YouTube short, so it's only 60 seconds. But I just wanted to go over some of the vocab that Alfredo pronounced for you guys in that video. We have la repostería. Repostería is the bakery section of the supermarket, okay, where you're going to find cupcakes and cakes and et cetera, pastries. El deli, I think that one's pretty straightforward. In Puerto Rico, they're not going to call it produce. The area of produce would just be called el área de frutas y vegetales. Some of the other areas of the store, we have las carnes, your meats, las carnes. We have la comida congelada, your frozen food. You have your productos lácteos. Productos lácteos, your dairy products. Are you not taking good notes right now? Or even if you are taking good notes, are you going to take the time to go back and add this vocab into your Quizlet? Because if not, you should sign up for our Patreon page where we're going to have all the vocab that I went over in today's episode ready for you in a Quizlet deck that you just have to click on and press review. $5 a month gives you access to all of the Quizlet decks as well as the transcripts from our episodes. Once you get to La Caja, in La Caja, at the cash register, which, by the way, you might have learned caja as box, which it is, but it also means a cash register, okay? El cajero y la cajera, therefore, are how you say cashier. El cajero masculine, la cajera feminine. Once you get to the cash register, your cajero or cajera might be asking you a couple questions, and that's what we're going to go over now. One other vocab word that I wanted to go over that we neglected to go over in the episode, this is something you'll hear anytime you're using a card. In Puerto Rico, they'll ask you for el numerito. In some places, they also might say el PIN. Okay, they might use PIN, but if not, you're going to be hearing numerito, and that means they're wanting you to type in your PIN for your debit card. All right, las preguntas que van a escuchar, the questions that you guys are going to hear, just as we went over in the episode, they're going to ask you perhaps efectivo, tarjeta, o simplemente el método de pago. Método de pago. They're going to ask you your payment method. Are you going to pay in cash or in card? Depending on where you go, depending on the person, the question might be asked differently. Where I go to do grocery shopping, it's usually método de pago. Since you have to pay for plastic bags in the grocery stores, they are going to ask you, ¿va a llevar bolsa? ¿Va a llevar bolsa? That's literally like saying, are you going to take a bag? That sounds really weird in English. So I just translated for what this would more naturally sound like in English. Will you need a bag? Okay, ¿va a llevar bolsa? Will you need a bag? Are you going to take a bag? Do I need to give you a bag? We also reviewed some other ways that they might ask this question. ¿Bolsa? ¿Desea? Or bolsita, they say, they might put the diminutive on it. This will always be a question in the grocery store since you have to pay for bags. So be prepared. Listen for bolsa. Bolsa va a llevar. Va a llevar bolsa. Bolsa, desea. Depending on the grocery store, they might also ask you if you're going to want any coffee, alcohol, or cigarettes. Okay. So that would sound like va a llevar café, licor, cigarrillos. Alfredo explained in the episode that these items are bajo llave. Bajo llave means they are locked away in their little case, okay? If you didn't know, most of the time you won't find café en los pasillos, in the aisles, in the grocery store, because it used to get stolen a lot. So they have it usually at the cash register, bajo llave, locked away. So that's why they're going to ask you that question once you're there, because they are the ones that are going to be able to facilitate giving you the coffee or alcohol or cigarettes. Finalmente, they might ask you el número de teléfono para los rewards. Not every grocery store does this. And of course, if you're just here traveling, this question doesn't apply to you. But if you want to sign up for rewards in some of the grocery stores that they have it, they might also ask you for your phone number to type in so that you get your little puntitos, you get your points. And now that you know what they're asking you, let's go over how to respond. When they ask you el método de pago or efectivo, tarjeta, you answer with how you're going to pay. I hear often ATH, ATH for your debit card to respond that you're going to be paying with a debit card. That means that they're going to know, they know that you're going to need to enter in a PIN. You might just say tarjeta. Okay, tarjeta would be card. You're not really specifying at that point if it's debit or a credit card. Tarjeta. Or efectivo is cash. In Puerto Rico, also the word cash is used. So don't be surprised if you hear that. When they ask you, ¿va a llevar bolsa? You will say, sí o no. Or as Alfredo said, he'll just go directly with the amount that he's going to ask for. So sí, dame tres, por favor, dame tres, bolsa. Give me three bags. I bring my bolsa reusable siempre, but I do. Yo llevo una bolsa para el pollo. We get raw chicken. I don't want the nasty poultry juices on my friggin' compra. Okay. So I usually say, sí, dame una pa'l pollo. Pa'l pollo, right? Puerto Rican contraction here would be that we drop the ra, para would turn into pa, and then we kind of smash that in with el, and it sounds like pa'l pollo. Dame una pa'l pollo. Give me one for the chicken. When they ask you if you're va a llevar café, licor, cigarrillo, you can say, no, no gracias, o sí, dame una bolsa de café, o sí. Do you want to talk about what kind of alcohol you're going to buy? Sí, voy a llevar, blah, 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 and luego you tell them what it is you want. If they ask you your phone number for the rewards, most of the time you're going to have to tell them your number. So again, make sure you're good, pretty efficient at saying your phone number in Spanish. And that's really all you need to know in order to successfully hacer compras in Puerto Rico, in order to successfully go grocery shopping in Puerto Rico. When we switched over to a local pharmacy or el colmado, your neighborhood store, your neighborhood market, Alfredo and I launched into a little script to have you guys hear what it might sound like when you're asking for an item that you can't find. So I wanted to go over that in today's episode. Let's look at those phrases I highlighted for you guys. So permiso, starting with permiso as excuse me. Some subtle differences between the con permiso, permiso, permisito por aquí is another one that you'll hear, okay? Con permiso is a good way when you need to get by somebody, and that might be the one that's used, con permiso. Permiso, more like, excuse me, you're trying to get someone's attention, right? Permiso, permiso, okay? So that's a slight difference. Con permiso might be a little bit more like trying to get by somebody. Permiso, you might be trying to get somebody's attention. You will also hear very often in Puerto Rico, permisito por aquí. I do that a lot in the grocery store. Let's say you are going to buy eggs. There's quite a few people there. You need to reach by and grab your carton. Often when I'm just reaching by somebody, I'll say permisito por aquí. Permisito por aquí. You'll hear that a lot from your fellow puertorriqueños en la isla. I wanted to remind you that the verb buscar, or in Puerto Rico more sound like buscar, means to look for. Do not follow it with por. Do not follow it with para. The verb buscar is not to look, so you don't need a for afterwards. The verb buscar means to look for, okay? So when you say estoy buscando, you're saying I'm looking for, and then you just fill in the item that you're looking for afterwards. Estoy buscando leche de almendra. I'm looking for almond milk, okay? Estoy buscando ajo, ajo en polvo. I'm looking for, how do we say that? Powdered garlic? Garlic powder. Alfredo told me that the papel de aluminio was in el pasillo tres. Pasillo, hallway, also aisle. Okay, if you were buying flight tickets in Spanish and you wanted an aisle seat, it would be el asiento del pasillo. En vez del asiento de la ventana, you would be in el asiento del pasillo if you were in the aisle seat. Pasillo, aisle, hallway. No lo encuentro. No lo encuentro. I can't find it. That's a more natural way to say it in Spanish than saying no lo puedo encontrar. This is the case in a lot of similar examples like no te escucho, I can't hear you. Or we in English and say, I can't hear you. You'd more naturally say no te escucho, I don't hear you in Spanish. Okay, good phrases for you guys to use. Obviously, this is a whole script, so we filled in a lot of fluff. I'm giving you the most useful phrases of that script. The phrase me llevo as a way to say I'll take. In a clothing store, for example, you might say me llevo esta. If you're holding on to a shirt, if you have it on your hanger and you're holding up, me llevo esta. I'm going to take this one. I'll take this one, all right? Me llevo esta. We're saying esta because we're talking about la camisa. And so feminine in that case. Really important phrase for shopping in general. When you're going to say, especially if you're deciding between two things, me llevo, I'm going to take, and then you specify which one it is you're going to choose. Lastly, in the part of this script, Alfredo gave me some directions of how to get to the other store. Some of the phrases I wanted to pull out from that section. Doblas a mano izquierda. Doblas a mano izquierda. Doblar, to turn. Do you turn to the left? When you hear a mano izquierda, a mano derecha, it's like saying the left-hand side or the right-hand side. Makes sense. That's how we do it in English as well. Left-hand side, right-hand side. You'll often hear this, especially if you're trying to find a bathroom, for example. You have to go down a hallway. On your right-hand side will be the bathroom. On the left-hand side is the bathroom for caballeros. And the right-hand side is the bathroom for las mujeres. You'll hear it like that. A mano derecha está el baño de las mujeres. A mano izquierda está el baño de los caballeros. Lo sigues derecho, a very classic phrase that you'll hear in Puerto Rico to just tell you to stay straight. Stay straight. Y al lado de is next to. We've got the verb for to turn. We've got your left and right hand side. You know now how to say keep straight. Sigues derecho, lo sigues derecho. And then next to is al lado de. Need to hang on to this vocab? Need to practice it and review it so that it stays in your head? Ya ustedes saben, sign up for Patreon. Y finalmente, en el mall o en una tienda de ropa, in the mall or in a clothing store, here's what you're going to hear. Here's what they're going to say to you. Lo que te van a decir. Lo que, what? What they're going to say to you. You'll hear something like, sí, buena, cualquier cosita me dejas saber. Sí, bueno, cualquier cosita, me deja saber. Hi, anything you need, let me know. Very common phrase in these settings is that someone's going to say to you, a la orden, okay? Aquí estamos a la orden. It doesn't have a direct translation, but it's like saying, if I can help, let me know. They might also ask you, ¿qué estás buscando? They might use amigo, amiga. Amiga, ¿qué estás buscando? ¿Qué estás buscando, amiga? ¿Qué estás buscando, amigo? What are you looking for? Some potential responses. If you're not looking for anything in particular, you could say, ah, no, no, estoy mirando, gracias. No, solo estoy mirando, I'm just looking. Solo estoy mirando. Gracias, te aviso cualquier cosa. Thanks, I'll let you know if I need anything. Thanks so much, I'll let you know. Again, that cualquier cosa, used very much in Spanish, where in English we might just not put anything there. Gracias, te aviso. Thanks, I'll let you know if I need anything. Gracias, te aviso cualquier cosa. Okay, so good responses. Ah, no, no, estoy mirando. Sounds very natural to use like that. No, no, solo estoy mirando. Gracias, te aviso cualquier cosa. Tying those two phrases together would sound really, really natural. No, I'm just looking. I'll let you know if I need anything. Thanks so much. For me personally, it's important to be kind and polite to people that are offering me a service. I talked about this as well in the restaurant episode. So I would say something along those lines. Ah, no, no, estoy mirando. Gracias, te aviso cualquier cosa. Gracias. What about if you need to try something on? A couple phrases to help you with that. Number one, you could say, ¿En dónde me puedo probar esto? ¿En dónde me puedo probar esto? So probar, which some of you might already know as the verb for to try, if you want it to be to try on, as in it's happening to your own body, it would become reflexive. You need probarse. ¿En dónde me puedo probar esto? You guys go back to this part of the episode again on YouTube, nice little chapters, skip right to the last chapter. You're going to hear Alfredo say it so fast that you can barely hear the May, but it's there. ¿En dónde puedo probar esto? ¿En dónde me puedo probar esto? That's as fast as I can do it. Obviously, native speakers can do it faster, run together better. ¿En dónde me puedo probar esto? ¿En dónde me puedo medir esto or esta? If you were holding up maybe una camisa. ¿En dónde me puedo medir esta camisa? Okay, where can I try this on? Or you might ask, ¿dónde están los probadores? ¿Dónde están los probadores? Probadores are your fitting rooms. It was interesting when we got to this section, what was my instinct was to say, ¿me puedo medir esto? ¿Me puedo medir esto? Because when I got here, it was pandemic and we couldn't try things on. So I got really used to asking if I could try something on, not just where I could try it on. Okay. Having to reshift my mindset here. Now I can ask, ¿en dónde me puedo probar esto? ¿En dónde me puedo medir esto? Is another way, medirse la ropa. In Puerto Rico is another very common way to use to try on clothes, okay? Probarse la ropa, medirse la ropa, or asking where the fitting rooms are, ¿dónde están los probadores? Finally, when you're paying at that store, you might hear some of the following questions, the typical questions that they would ask you in a retail type situation. Encontró todo lo que buscaba. Encontró todo lo que buscaba. They're likely going to be speaking to you en usted. Okay, so here is, did you find everything you were looking for? For people that are working on the two past tenses, notice this is an interesting use of the two past tenses, right? You were looking for is like an in-process action. They don't know if it's finished. Here we are paying, so they are asking, did you find everything that you were in the process of looking for? Kind of an interesting view of preterite and imperfect interacting here. Okay, at that point, you would answer, sí o no. If you did not find something you're looking for, tell them no and say, no, de hecho, estaba buscando tal cosa. I was looking for this, pero no lo tienen, ¿verdad? Oh, no. If they end up, or if it's just that you missed it, they might say, ah, sí, está ahí, and they'll tell you where. They might ask for el email. They use the word email here. It'll just sound a little bit more like email. El número de teléfono, they might ask for your phone number as well, all these things they do to send you 1,000 alerts about their sales. And I mentioned that they might also let you know what la política de devolución is. La política de devolución is the return policy. Una devolución is a return. It's the noun form of the verb devolver. Devolver is to return an item, to return something to somewhere, to someone. Okay, so it makes sense. Turning that verb into a noun for to say a return would be una devolución. Una devolución. Therefore, the return policy is la política de devolución. Would you like to feel more confident in using all these and feel like they just roll off the tip of your tongue and you don't have to think about it and start to sweat when you have these interactions? Well, then I highly suggest you sign up for our Patreon. patreon.com, Spanish with Carrie, you'll see that we have all of the decks here of the episodes we've done with the vocab already set for you. All you got to do is click and start reviewing. $5 a month. Totally worth it. And here's 64 members that agree. It's freaking worth it. Thanks so much for listening. Thanks so much for your support. Find me on social media at Spanish with Carrie. Y hasta el próximo.